At the turn of the millennium, John Titor claims that he is a time traveler from the year 2036 and shares photographic evidence of his time machine's operation manual. He says he works as a time traveler for the American military and that his mission was to retrieve an old computer from 1975, which would help resolve a software bug in the future. He has made a personal stop in the year 2000 to meet his family, whom he misses a lot. He speaks of a dark dystopian future for all of humanity and then disappears into the temporally fleeting sunset, never to be heard from again. In 2003, Andrew Carlson invests $800 in the stock exchange and in just a matter of 2 weeks, grows his portfolio to $350 million. He is arrested for insider trading by the SEC, but he defends himself by stating that he is a time traveler from the year 2256. A mysterious man posts his bail. Carlson does not show up for the hearing and is never seen again. Records show that he never existed. Incredible stories of time travelers such as Titor and Carlson have been widely dismissed as myths and well-crafted hoaxes, but remain etched in geek folklore. The fascinating concept of time travel has been explored in pop culture through literature, film, and television for centuries. But is time travel ever going to be a reality? Many scientific researchers believe we are closer now than ever before to embark on this fantastic adventure through the fabric of space and time.
We can easily travel forward in time, and we've known how to do that since 1905. Einstein's special theory of relativity lays out the whole recipe of how you can move into the future.
So, the question arises, if we are on the verge of inventing time travel today, can we assume that at some point in the future, we succeed at inventing it? If the answer is yes, we are presented by our first logical contradiction, the Fermi Paradox. Simply put, if time travel were possible in the future, why aren't the time travelers here today? After all, if it were possible to travel through time, would we not have bumped into these temporal visitors? On June 28, 2009, physicist Stephen Hawking carried out a scientific experiment which was meant to answer this question once and for all. He brought snacks, balloons, and champagne, and hosted a secret party for time travelers.
A welcome reception for future time travelers. But there's a twist. I'm not letting anyone know about it until after the party has happened. Here is the invitation, giving the exact coordinates in time and space. Maybe, one day, someone living in the future will find the information and use a wormhole time machine to come back to my party, proving that time travel will, one day, be possible. My time traveler guests could be arriving any moment now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What a shame.
Is it possible that his guests showed up in an alternate universe, or will they arrive a few decades late? Because somehow backwards, time travel does not get perfected, and travelers to the past cannot accurately pinpoint their exact time destination. Or perhaps it is simply not possible to accomplish, as it goes against the laws of relativity.
Traveling backwards, that's the problem. If you manage to travel faster than light, you have the capacity to move backwards in time. We just don't have any easy way to travel faster than light.
As an object approaches the speed of light, it would gain infinite mass, while its length would diminish to zero. The heavier the object becomes, the more energy it would require for acceleration. Therefore, it would take an infinite amount of energy to make an object reach the speed of light. Our science is not advanced enough to enable this yet, but theoretical physicists and researchers have proposed some workarounds to overcome this barrier and facilitate faster-than-light travel.
Depending on a trajectory you take around a black hole, you can come out and end up in the past of when you started, or it could travel through a wormhole that changes the effective distance between where you are and where you're going. And then you sort of look around when you get there and you find, oh my gosh, I've traveled 100,000 light years in a matter of a moment. When you do that, you have the capacity to move backwards in time relative to when you left.
The counterintuitive landscape of Einstein's theory gives rise to situations that seem unfathomable. If time travel does become possible in the future, we would be faced with some bizarre temporal inconsistency paradoxes that have been hypothesized in many fictional works and scientific papers. The most commonly explored hypothesis is the twin paradox. The protagonists of this anomaly are two identical twin brothers. Let's imagine that one of them takes a round trip into space at 99.9% of the speed of light. Due to time dilation, time runs more slowly on his spacecraft than it does on Earth. Therefore, when he returns home, he will be younger than his brother who stayed behind. Another anomaly explored frequently is the predestination paradox, also known as a time loop or causal loop. Imagine that your loved one dies in a hit-and-run incident, and that goads you to travel back in time to save her, only to discover that you are the one who runs her over in the first place. No matter how many times you try to save her, the end result is always the same. You are now stuck in a time loop. One more type of temporal paradox is the bootstrap paradox. Let's imagine that you live in the future where time travel is possible. You love the musical works of Beethoven and wonder what it would be like to meet him in person. One day you have a diabolical idea to go back in time and meet young Ludwig. You gift him his very own magnum opus, the Fifth Symphony, much before he's even conceived of it. An intrigued Beethoven listens to it, replicates the notations, chords, and progressions, and releases it in 2018 as it was always meant to be. History remains unaltered, but the big question now is, who composed this masterpiece after all? Apart from these time loop paradoxes, there are ones where you can actually alter your historical timeline. These are called consistency paradoxes. The most common one is the grandfather paradox. If you traveled to the past and killed your grandfather, before he met your grandmother, your entire family line would cease to exist. You would have never been born, and consequently, would not have been able to travel to the past to kill your grandfather. Another variant of the grandfather paradox is the Hitler paradox. If you go back in time and kill Hitler when he was young, you would stop him from committing atrocities. The Holocaust would be avoided. World War II would never take place. Millions of lives would be saved. You wouldn't read about him in school, and so you wouldn't have a reason to go back and kill Hitler. Time travel is inevitable. When it happens, the concept of time itself will lose meaning.
When they invent a time machine, all time ceases to become linear. So there's no, like, tomorrow will be Wednesday and the next day will be Thursday. No. It's everything happens everywhere all at once. You can never own anything because someone could just travel through time and take it away from you when you weren't looking. There would be no normal life anymore. There's not going to be any sort of structure to life. How can anybody invent things when they can just travel to a point where someone invented it already? What's to stop people from going back before them and taking the idea and introducing it before that? Thus, there'll be no intellectual property because there'll be no way to say you came up with it first. Instantaneously, you'll become immortal because whatever we have right now in terms of technology, what we're gonna have in a million years is gonna be godlike. The world itself would be completely unrecognizable because time would mean nothing.
Until we invent time travel, we can only wonder what the future holds for us. Only time will tell.